ceremony. Thank you for making this day so very memorable for the class of 2015. Today is one of the most important days in the life of each one of the graduates and their family. We hope you'll help us in making this a dignified ceremony and one in which each graduate receives full recognition for his or her accomplishments. To do this, we ask for your cooperation. During the ceremony, we ask that you hold your applause until each row has received their diplomas. We want everyone to have the pleasure of hearing the graduate's name announced and seeing your graduate receive his or her diploma. You are taking pictures. Please try not to block the view of others in the crowd by getting in front of people or getting too close to the stage. Our ushers will assist the audience in requiring you to remain seated or quickly return to your seat throughout the ceremony. At this time, we will begin our ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, the faculty of Affton High. Learners. Ms. Angela Early, Social Studies. Michael Williams, Special School District. Ms. Melissa Yost, Special School District. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2015.
Thank you.
Bill Wells and the Affton High Band for the beautiful processional music. Please join me in welcoming members of the Board of Education. Board President, Mr. Tom Bellavia. Board Vice President, Mr. Chris Castellanos. Board Treasurer, Mrs. Susan Cangelegi. Board Director, Mr. Doug Beck. Board Director, Mr. Larry Knox. And Board Director, Mrs. Patricia Zahn. Also, our Assistant Superintendent, Dr. Travis Brock. And our Superintendent, Dr. Steve Brotherton. Faculty and staff and friends and members of the class of 2015. We want to take this opportunity so close to Memorial Weekend to honor those with us today who served our country in the past, who are presently serving, and who will serve in the future. Please stand and be recognized, please. Today, these graduates are stepping into tomorrow. The focus of their lives will change in many ways as they leave the comfort of this school and the educators who have helped them. At this time, and for the last time, Mr. Phil Bierman, the principal to the senior class, will share some thoughts with the class of 2015.
Thank you, everyone. Board members, administration, parents, guests, and Affton seniors. I always take pride in this opportunity to say a few words to the graduating class. I feel it's an opportunity to speak to them with some final words that they may find inspiring. So for the last time, here goes. They say timing is everything. And I couldn't think of a better time than now to finish up my career and graduate, if you want to call it that, than with the class of 2015 from Affton High School. You know, in my position, I get the opportunity to witness each class as they come in as freshmen and observe in those 4 short years the progress these young adults make academically, physically, and with maturity. With this particular class, there has been tremendous achievements in all those areas. Looking at the monetary amount of scholarships they've earned, along with the number of athletic scholarships, and lastly, the minimal amount of discipline handed out from my office, and I appreciate that. It goes without saying, the class of 2015 has been a special class. Soon to be graduating, this is the first leg of your future careers in life. You have all completed this stage successfully. Take pride in how far you've come. Have faith in how far you can go. But don't forget to enjoy that journey. You must now go on and continue on the road of your lifelong ambitions and what you want to do for a career. Graduation today is not the end, it's the beginning. Don't panic if you're not sure yet of what you want to do in life. That's okay. It happened to me, and it worked out pretty well. It will come to you at some time in your future, and once it does, don't let anything get in your way of reaching your goals. Seniors, my last bit of advice would be this. Your families are extremely proud of you. You can't imagine the sense of relief they are experiencing right now. Hang on. Seniors, this would be a most opportune time to ask them for money later this evening. Thank you very much.
At this time, Mr. Tim Lukey, the assistant principal of the class, will introduce the salutatorian for the class of 2015.
Good evening. At this time, please join me in congratulating this year's salutatorian for the class of 2015, Esit Mustafich. Semesters at Affton High School, Esit is graduating with a cumulative GPA of 4.35. And now Esit, here's the part I told you about, okay? He's a recipient of the Affton High School Academic Wall of Fame. He's a Bright Flight Award winner, High Honor Award winner with a 4.0 GPA plus. President's Award for Educational Excellence, the Athens Parents Club Scholarship winner, National Honor Society member, National French Honor Society member, International Club Officer, HOSA member, Rotary Youth Leadership Academy, Federation of Balkan American Association, Rams Blitz Program, Teams member, Mathletes member, and officer. As the billboards around town say, Esit will continue his education and be a Billiken at St. Louis University. And we'll... and is going to pursue a degree in neuroscience. At this time, he will address all of you.
Whether or not you fell in love with Mr. Nice's class sophomore year during sixth hour, oh, December 19th at approximately 1 o'clock, embarrassed standpoint of the best debate in the history of Mr. Esselman's class, went on the tallest water slide in the world at Hosa Nationals, or saw Mr. Michael in a short blue prom dress. Your high school days must have been amazing, because you were surrounded by some of the smartest and most caring teachers and students around. Looking around, I see future doctors, lawyers, teachers, and guys from Chris McNamee who found to freak out us. We were nobodies a couple years back. This year, we ran the school. Some might even say, we started from the bottom, now we're here. We've had a lot of hilarious moments over the years and plenty of struggles as well. Each situation taught us a lesson or reaffirmed another. Here are just a couple lessons I want to pass on to you. There's hell and hello, good and goodbye, lie and believe, over and lover, and a friend, and an infant wife. A man only shows who he really is when he wears a mask. It's not plagiarism if you change some of the words. Or something like that. You shouldn't compare yourself to others. It's silly. When you open a box of pizza, it doesn't matter which slice has more or less toppings or which is bigger than the others. Pizza is pizza. Pizza is delicious. You are delicious. When someone changes, it's really the disguise that comes off. Always forgive, but never forget. And finally, we read Shakespeare rather than John Green in high school, not because Mr. Jennings wanted us to struggle with Old English, but rather because life is not written in the stars. We are the masters of our own destinies. The class of 2015 is the master of its destiny. I want each and every single one of you to sit straight up and face the cameras. Not only because you are great people, but because if this graduation isn't on Twitter, Facebook, and Snapchat, did it really even happen? I want to thank Wikipedia, Big Media, Google, the inventor of copy and paste, my friends for making me laugh, my mom for pushing me to fulfill my potential, my dad for showing me the value of an education, my brother for giving me a reason to make myself an actual role model, my teachers for explaining the world, and finally, I would like to thank everyone in the audience, whether asleep or not, sitting through this. Seniors, I'll see you at the slumber party tonight. Thank you and salute.
Each year at graduation, seniors who have been part of the choir present their musical tribute to the graduating class. So we welcome now the choirs under the direction of our choir director, Mr. Dale Fernley, as they perform two musical selections.
Maybe all my life's way.
firmly in the choir. It is a tradition at commencement, a member of the Affton High School faculty shares some thoughts with the graduate. Mr. Chris Foley, the 2015 Affton High Teacher of the Year, will have the honor of addressing this class. Mr. Foley.
Board members, administrators, colleagues, families, friends, enemies, thank you. You know, I ran into a colleague of mine after school yesterday, and as he got up, he said to me, are you all prepared for your speech tomorrow night? And at that point, it dawned on me that I should probably prepare something for the speech tonight. And so I took a page out of the senior's book here in the class of 2015, like Mr. Mustafa alluded to, and last night I went to the internet and typed in graduation speeches and printed the first one, so this is what you get. I'd like to be the first to officially congratulate the class of 2006 here at Stanford University. So that probably wasn't the best idea. So let me pull the curtain back just a little bit with respect to the class of 2015. 3 years ago, I went up to a colleague and I approached him and I said, do you teach any sophomores this year? And he said, I don't. Why? I said, well, let me tell you something. I said, I think the sophomores, the class of 2015, I said, I think they might eventually go down as one of the best classes that this school has ever seen. I said, academically speaking, athletically speaking, and just from a spirit of involvement, not only at the school, but in the community, thought this might ultimately be one of the best classes that we ever had. And that colleague said, I look forward to teaching them as juniors next year. Thank you for the information. Now, will you let me please finish going to the restroom? And what I realized was 3 years later, is that those predictions, those thoughts, absolutely came true. This has turned out to be one of the best, if not the best, classes that this high school has ever graduated. From an athletic standpoint, from an academic standpoint, from a philanthropic standpoint, beyond description, this class is great. And just as an illustration of their greatness, and Mr. Bierman alluded to this earlier, $6.2 million in scholarships earned by the individuals that are on this stage. To give you a picture, just an idea as to how much $6.2 million is, all you have to do is picture 62 million dimes. And that represents $6.2 million, which is what they've earned. But it wouldn't be appropriate for me to be here tonight without bringing the class of 2015 some statistics, of which 99.7% confident they'll find value. For example, statistics show that of all of you pursuing work next year, 1.26 of you will not be able to find a job. I hope it's not you, and I hope that you make those choices to avoid being part of that statistic. Statistics show that of all of you going off to college next year, 62.56 of you will not finish college. I hope it's not you. I hope you're not that statistic. And I hope that you make choices to avoid that group. In fact, statistics show that 4 years from now, one of you won't even be here. Again, I hope it's not you. And I hope that you're making choices that are for the betterment of yourself to avoid being that statistic. But it wouldn't be appropriate for me just to bring a whole bunch of bad and negative numbers to the conversation. Most of you would say I did that enough in class. So let's talk about some positive numbers. And in fact, for that I'll ask for your efforts, if you would indulge me just a bit, to illustrate all the positive statistics that the class of 2015 offers. If you would, please, if you would stand up if at some point in your high school career you took an AP exam, or if you were an athlete, stand up, or if you were a member of some club or some organization, or if you were an actor or an actress. This right here represents the sheer magnificence of which we speak of the class of 2015 and how much they've contributed to this school and how much their legacy not only exists today, but will have a long influence long after they're gone. Thank you, guys. You can sit down. But how about one more statistic? How about the number zero? Because that's how many of you will be students at this school in just a few hours. And while that initially might elicit feelings of excitement and feelings of joy, hopefully you understand the other implications behind that number. The comfort that you've grown accustomed to for the last 13 years, it ends. The nice track that you've had, where you've had people willing to help you make decisions, or in some cases, make the decisions for you, that all goes away. And you now become the sole authors of your own destiny. You become the key author of your own autobiography for what will hopefully be many, many more chapters. So I wanted to close with something memorable. So how about some things that you should know moving forward into the world? Things like, be proud of who you are. Be proud of who you were. Be proud of the person that you are to be. All of your faults and all of your strengths, all of your weaknesses, they create the person that you are. And it's through pride in yourself and confidence in yourself that you will grow to be an even better person in the future. Secondly, don't rest on past success. You might have been the MVP of the balloon pop at sports night your sophomore year, but I'm gonna be honest with you, nobody cares. And in fact, I should tell you this, and I hate to tell this to you on what should be a really, really happy day, but there's a lot of people outside of this district that have never heard of sports night. They have no idea what it is. The third thing I'd like for you to know is be inspired to make a change. Be inspired to change yourself, to change the world, to change the community, but understand that change that is physical goes away. Things that are built, they disappear over time. Make your inspiration to be change that is intangible, that will stand the test of time. Now, it doesn't mean when I say you should go out to make change that your goal should be to be on television or to get your name in the paper in some way. And just, well, you guys know what newspapers are, right? You still know that? They print 30 pages of the internet and throw it at your house every day. So you shouldn't look to necessarily be famous, but look to create change that betters yourself and betters the environment that you live in. And the fourth thing is think about the choices that you make. Your life could be viewed as a whole series of millions and millions of choices that have led you to this moment. Think about the impact, the consequences of every choice that you will face now and in the future, and let it shape you into becoming a better person as you try to instill change upon the world. I mean, what you need to think about is, how am I going to embrace the challenge of creating change and use these choices to not just seize the day, but to seize the moment as well? I mean, you have to figure out real quick. I promise nobody told me there was a time limit. No? After all these years, we're finally here. But what's next? That's for you to decide. Let's do this. Your palms are sweaty, the cap makes your head feel heavy. You're getting prepared to walk gracefully and steady. 18 years later, and you're finally ready to cross the stage and get that diploma already. Time to say goodbye. Start to think of the top, the good and the bad times. Tears come to your eyes. And all the while, how you got your own smile and your very own style. Stage seems like a knife. Backhand situation, the city's graduation, and the celebration of resolve, determination, station to station. This culmination is forever a part of this culmination. Has been years behind you, drawing into the rear. To yourself, you've been true, fear and goal, and now you keep all that you do, the goals you pursue. And graduate now, describe. Prove yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. This is your thing, you only get one shot from here on out. So make your choices count, you got to think. You better lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. This is your thing, you only get one shot. So make your choices count, you got to think. Learning your math or the ABCs tested. I think they mastered plenty of these, the ACT, the SAT, the EOC, or the MAP. Started at the grade of three. Others got college credit, room AP. Some of you got 5 for 4 years of straight D's. But you all made more than you should be pleased. So appease the pleas of your parents when they just say, say cheese, it doesn't matter the means or the path. Y'all got a common aftermath. Diploma in your hand, you grads after that. Go tackle the world, no turning back. Your life now becomes a solo track. Family and friends are just supporting cast. To yourself, you gotta make this path. Or I'll go get my all, no effort lack. Lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. If it's your thing, you only get one shot. So make your choices count, you got to think. Lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. If it's your thing, you only get one shot. So make those choices count, you got to think. So what's next, what happens after today? He's got to spare. It carries so much weight, it's even heavier than the sports night trophy you raised. And what you do with it is so clean, you'll say. And some would you stay and defend this place. For them, we'll bring rep in the USA. We hope that they're safe and that they stay okay. Each and every day, on our conscience, it will weigh. Some will choose to stray and join the labor force. With no remorse for why until their discourse is forced. Every single day looking for that light source. And if they fall down, get back up on the horse. Others go off and get the college degree. You see, they're free from high school, but they just have to see. Some might stay local and some might flee. We're proud of you all for taking on the. Soon to be all nighters, the stress that's getting tired. Doing everything to make your mind get wider. Fighting the fight to make the future even brighter. At the end of the night, you know you're tired. It doesn't matter the path or what you do. Understand that your future is all on you. The more you grew, the more you knew. Just choose what's right and true and see it through. Lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. You did your thing, you only get one shot from here on out. So make your choices count, you got to think. Lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. You did your thing, you only get one shot from here on out. So make your choices count, you got to think. Thank you, Pastor, for this congratulations.
Thank you.
2015, these students have held official positions of leadership through the 2014-15 school year. Would you please stand as I call your name and remain standing until all have been introduced? The senior class officers, Justine Pipitone, Jane Sykes, Olivia Owens, and Jordan Comier. Student Council President, Olivia Owens. National Honor Society officers, President Sam Pointer, Vice President Anna Pine, Secretary Courtney Kroger, Treasurer Essa Gustafich, and Parliamentarian Troy Howe. Thank you, you may be seated. Attendance has been our goal here at Affton High over the past years. We've had only one student with perfect attendance for all 4 years in high school. Please stand and be recognized, Adam Connor. Besides high academic achievement, the class of 2015 has been active in many organizations and clubs and athletics, as Mr. Bowley alluded to. But I would like all the seniors who have been active in the following organizations to stand and remain standing until everyone has been recognized. National Honor Society. Student Council. French Honor Society. Math Please. DECA FBLA. Thespians. Trend. Varsity Sports Club. Diversity Club and Athletics. As you can see, the class of 2015 has been very involved in all aspects of Affton High. They have promoted a culture of service and involvement in addition to their high academic achievement. Thank you, you may be seated. This year, we are pleased to announce that 83 graduates have met the qualification for the A+ program. These graduates will be able to attend the first 2 years of college tuition-free due to their high GPA, attendance, and service work through high school. If you have met the qualifications for the A+ program, please stand and be recognized. Extended to Affton High senior class principal, Mr. Phil Bierman, and senior class sponsor, Heather Mayfield and Jan Nelson. We thank you for making this a successful and memorable senior year, full of all the traditional senior activities. Ceremonies such as this, as the commencement exercise, are significant events in our lives. Today gives us an opportunity to reflect upon past accomplishments, but it is in the present that we determine the future. And once again, this class of 2015 graduating class leaves behind a legacy of even higher achievement. This year, the Affton High School was honored by being recognized for Advanced Placement Board by just being one of just 10 districts in Missouri who made the AP Honor Roll for an increased number of students who were taking the AP exams and scoring a 3 or better on the exams to qualify for college credit. We are also very proud of the academic achievement of these graduates. Prior to this year, $4.8 million in scholarships was the highest total a class had ever achieved. But this year, the class of 2015 had $6.2 million in merit-based scholarship offers. A tremendous accomplishment. If you have been offered or accepted a scholarship, please stand and be recognized for your accomplishment. You may be seated. A diploma from Affton High is a symbol of hard work and successful completion of 13 years of education. Although the staff of Affton High has most recently had the pleasure of working with these seniors, there have been teachers and counselors and principals who's guided them through their years in school. The class has been nurtured by their parents, relatives, and the community. They have been taught and cared for by the faculty of Manier, Gotch, Rogers, and now for the past years, Affton High. So So graduates, the auditorium is filled with those who have come to honor and congratulate you. I want you to acknowledge the dedicated faculty for the many ways that the faculty have touched the lives and members of this class. I especially thank and acknowledge the parents and guardians of our seniors. You have given so much of yourself to help our seniors arrive at this moment. So graduates, at this time, I invite you to stand as a class and applaud the faculty, your parents, relatives, and friends who have given so much to you. And so, Dr. Brotherton, I'm pleased to inform you publicly that according to the official records of Affton High School, each member of this class of 2015 who is seated on the stage today has met all the graduation requirements as prescribed by the Affton Board of Education, the Missouri Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, and the laws of the state of Missouri. It's my pleasure at this time to present this class to you for your acceptance. Our superintendent, Dr. Steve Brotherton, will address the class.
So at this time, I'd like to offer my congratulations to the class of 2015, and I'd like to welcome their family and friends. I appreciate your attendance and the support that you've given them throughout their time here at Affton, and I know they appreciate that as well. You began your journey at Affton High School 4 years ago, and coincidentally, I became superintendent of the Affton School District 4 years ago. So it's been my pleasure to watch you grow and see you finish strong. In our school district, we talk about being Affton strong, and each of our buildings has a mantra. So at our early childhood center, our students play strong. At Manier, which is our building that's K-2, our students start strong. At our third through fifth grade building, they learn strong, grow strong, grow strong at Gotch. At Rogers, we think strong, and at the high school, we finish strong. I'm very proud of all of your accomplishments, as we've heard tonight. And I'm proud to say that because the class of 2015 has met all the requirements set forth by the state of Missouri and by the Board of Education, I would like to accept this class on behalf of the Board of Education and the entire Affton community. So congratulations, and we look forward to hearing great things about you in the future.
At this time, awarding the diplomas to the graduates will be the Affton Board of Education members, Mr. Doug Beck, Mr. Tom Bellavia, Mr. Chris Castellanos, Ms. Sue Kejaleggi, Mr. Larry Knox, and Ms. Patricia Zahn. Mr. Phil Bierman, the assistant principal to the senior class, will read the names of the graduates. Please hold your applause for individual graduates, and all the graduates' names may be heard row by row. So ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2015.
There was one oversight on the class officers. I want to recognize Haley Sarah. Haley, stand up. And Elena Kennedy. Okay. Roll one, stand up, please. Face me. Kayla Aguilera Garcia. Sergey Alt. Caitlin Armbruster. Safika Abdich. Cedar Berzanji. Jesse Bauer. Emily Byron.
Addison Bearden. Elma Bezlanji. Joe Bingerson. Elmadin Bertzel. Paige Black. Matt Blessing. Benjamin Roderich. Tariq Bulyabasic. Devin Burke. Danielle Caruso. Brittany Ketchum. Ryan Kazabah. Endry Sino. Emily Bowe. Brooke Brust. Joshua Ellis. Elise Marvin. Abigail Slay. Asen Mustafic. Addis Terzic. Face the audience, roll one. Congratulations. Row two, stand up, come forward. Elena Chappie. Meldisa Surratt. Kaylee Compton. Adam Connor. Emily Doherty. Deja Davis. Noon Lee Dim. Chase DeLuna. Brittany Dennis. Brandon DeVault. Mitchell Noli. Abdo Gergotovich. Bradley Ferris. Dakota Fisher. Nick Fogel. Ashley French. Jonathan Fry. Shane Frick. Alexis Frischman. Michael Fulcomer. Kristen Funky. Caitlin Gamash. Jacob Gardner. Malachi Gitcomb. Arnella Gladovich. Ashley Goodman. Katie Gordon. Amir Haziz Alahovich. Abigail Rose Haldeman. Risa Hale. Sarah Halabasic. Just Harden. David Harris. John Harris. Maya Harris. Adisa Hage. Abigail Hill. Armin Hasich. Hannah Holman. Congratulations, Row 2. Row 3, stand up. Come forward. Valerie Hollowell. Madiha Huzanovich. Caitlin Jenkins. Trayvon Johnson. Jonathan Suarez. Troy Kelly. Almedina Kakich. Sean Kenny. Mandy Clem. Joseph Connorsmith. Elvisa Kranich. Courtney Kroger. Cameron Cooks. Jacob Latore. Leggett. Noah Linder. Westerman Lindor. Evan Lynn. Devondre Love. Addie Matmakovich. Hilmo Mokic. Katie Marks. Carmen Martinez. Catherine McAllister. Christopher McAllister. Amina Mimic. Cody Menicki. Austin Meyer. Vanessa Mazinas. Julie Milson. Caitlin Moore. Venetia Morgan. Muyo Mamanovich. Aida Muzovich. Mai Nguyen. Elvis Nixon. Mark O'Brien. Congratulations. Thank you. Roll forward, stand up, come forward. Brendan O'Fallon. Emily Allegas. Maggie Oster. Olivia Owens. Jana Parla. Natasha Pierre. Justine Tripitone. Sam Pointer. Izette Perovich. Taylor Reese. Nick Ryring. Gavin Roby. Sabat Sabir. Dylan Sarkic. Darcy Schmidt. Al Schultz. Ashley Schwer. Baroon Scoop. Erman Solovich. Haley Sarah. Wilbur Sharp. Daniel Sheldon. Anjanea Sims. Alexander Searless. Otto Smeich. Brandon Smith. Brianna Smith. Cody Smith. Kyle Smith. Victoria Smith. Nathan Spies. Jane Spiro. Jasmine Stallman. John Stewart. Congratulations. Row 5, stand up, come forward.
Sorry.
Good. Carrie Stewart. Randy Stringer. Ben Suskich.
You first heard the diploma!
Kayla Swain. Everett Swires. Jane Sykes. Carson Talley. Tessa Taylor.
Go, Tessa.
Jimmy Terranova. Adela Terzich. Alex Stark. Tori Thompson. Jordan Tamier. Jacob Toby. Stephanie Tomas. Samantha Tomlin. Amy Tran. Troy June. Amir Tuzlich. Anthony Ursler. Justin Valdez. Teepak Borghese. Anna Versaput.
Yeah! Oh, my baby!
Sateo Walker. Yeah! Claire Wall. Jack Weber. Brendan Welsh. Luke Westbrook. Marnay Williams. Andrew Wilson. Kelsey Winfrey. Joe Wyrick. Jessica Wright. Tyler Wright. Congratulations. He's here.
At this time, I'm honored to present to you the valedictorian of the class of 2015, Otis Terzic. He has the President's Award for Educational Excellence, the Don Kuhn Award, Affton Education Foundation Scholarship winner, Missouri Scholars 100 Award recipient, National Honor Society member, Student Council Executive Committee, DECA FBLA member, the host of Vice President and President, NCADA representative, scholar athlete for boys basketball and volleyball, the Bowling Fund Relay for Life Executive Committee, UMSL Distinguished Achievement Excellence in Science recipient, a Mathletes member and officer, Drama Club member, and Star Research Scholar. Otis will continue his education at Washington University to pursue a degree in biology. Yeah.
It's good. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Adis Terzic, and it is my pleasure to stand before you all and give my valedictory address. Before my address, though, I would like to do two things first. For one, I think it's important to recognize that this is a huge, huge honor for you all to be here listening to me. What a treat for you all. Also, on a serious note, I would just like to give a quick shout out to my father.
Yeah!
That was him just But he has raised me for the past 18 years, and without him, I don't know where I'd be. He's the man I look up to, and I just want to thank him and say I love you, Dad. Yeah. Now, on to my actual speech. As I begin, I think it's really important that we reflect on our past 4 years at Affton High School. We've all made leaps and bounds throughout our years at Affton, and not only have we changed in terms of appearance, thank you to puberty, but we have changed in terms of our personality, independence, and demeanor. A few of us have even matured. Now, it goes without saying that through all of this change that we have experienced, the class of 2015 is without a doubt the greatest group of students to walk the halls of Affton. As you've heard from prior speeches today, the numbers and accomplishments speak for themselves. The three sports night titles in a row, we have even amassed the greatest amount of scholarships in Athens history, $6.2 million, among many other great accomplishments. All of this success is something to be greatly proud of and something we all need to be congratulated for. Now, there's also another piece to this whole puzzle, and that is our wonderful teachers and staff. We have been blessed with some of the finest teachers we could possibly have. It is clear that every single one of our teachers are dedicated to their job and love what they do. That is important not only because our teaching staff is extremely intelligent and engaged in the material being taught, but throughout high schools, my teachers have engaged me and made learning something enjoyable. I know many other fellow graduates would say the same. I mean, who could say they didn't enjoy Mr. Bowley's dry humor and professionalism? I definitely know everyone enjoyed his amazing speech and rap. A little thing about him, everywhere he went, the man wore a long sleeve dress shirt and slacks, even if it were 95 degrees outside in the middle of summer. I remember he even went so far as to wear fake tattoo sleeves under his white dress shirt one day to make it look as if he had tattoos. That he was kind of playing along with the rumor that he wears the long dress shirt, the long sleeve dress shirt, because he has tattoos. Now, what about Mr. Jennings? He wore sandals every day to school, and he had his unorthodox teaching methods. I remember the first day of his class in AP Lit junior year, or AP Language junior year, all we did for the first day was blow bubbles outside and write. Or, how about Mr. Espin? He may be one of the smartest men I know. You can ask anyone here on stage or talk to him and you can find out yourself. But that isn't his greatest asset. He has fists of steel. If you ever sit in his class, you will know he bangs on that podium relentlessly. That it's very surprising that it's still standing. Or what about Mr. Moiko? He makes everything about his class realistic. Whether you are participating in a class project, creating and executing a campaign to run for president, or enduring an earthquake drill where he throws markers to simulate the earthquake, everything is practical and important to our learning in that class. This is just a snapshot of our amazing teachers. There is so much more that can be said about each teacher, and it is important for us to recognize all the teachers and staff for their wonderful work. I want to thank them for making high school an astounding 4 years of learning and shaping this class of 2015. So if we could please give them a round of applause. Now, Now, as we look on to the future, the prospects for the class of 2015 look bright. As Ms. Jackson would say, the future for the class of 2015 looks very good. Now, of course, all of this praise is warranted, and it has been amazing to be a part of such an amazing class. It is something I will remember for the rest of my life. At the same time, I would like to relay a few words of wisdom. If there is anything that anyone takes away from this speech, I hope it is this. We all control our own life paths and what we end up doing in our lives. Our subsequent happiness is mostly determined by what actions we take. With that, I hope no one on this stage lets fear deter them from achieving what they want to accomplish. I know nobody's perfect, and we all have our fears and flaws. But we shouldn't let the prospects of failure or other people's thoughts dictate our actions. I want this class of 2015 to dare to achieve and be inspired. With such little time on this earth, it is important to make the most out of it. That is why I don't want anyone worrying about what could go wrong or living in fear. As a wise man once said, all fear lies in anticipation. And that is why I simply want my classmates to go out there and not worry about ifs and buts. Just simply do. In cooler terms, Ricky Bobby once said, I'm the best there is, plain and simple. I wake up in the morning and I piss excellence. Class of 2015, as we go forth into this next stage of our lives, I compel you to worry not about failure and mishaps, but rather dare to achieve, and above all else, piss excellence. Thank you very much. Their tassels from left to right to symbolize our graduation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Addis. Very good. On behalf of the members of the class of 2015, the faculty, the staff, the administration, and the Board of Education, I want to thank you for attending today's commencement. The graduates and staff will exit the auditorium through the side doors. We ask that the audience remain seated until all the graduates have left the auditorium. But our recessional right now will begin with the faculty. Mr. Wells.
Embrace the challenge of creating change and use these choices to not just seize the day, but to seize the moment as well. I mean, you have to figure out. I wasn't done. Can that be turned off? I'll be real quick. I promise nobody told me there was a time. No? You have finally arrived. After all these years, you're finally here. But what's next? That's for you to decide. Let's do this. Your palms are sweaty, the cat makes your head feel heavy. You're getting prepared to walk gracefully and steady. 18 years later, and you're finally ready to cross the stage and get that poem already. Time to say goodbye. Start to think of the top, the good and the bad times. Tears come to your eyes. And all the while, how you get your own smile and your very own style. Stage seems like a knot. Back in the situation, the city's congratulation and the celebration of resolve, determination, compensation, the station. This, the culmination, is forever a part of this determination. Has been years behind you, driving into the rear. To yourself, you've been true, fear and soul, and now all that you do, the goals you pursue. And graduate now, describe prove yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. This is your thing, you only get one shot from here on out, so make your choices count, you got to think. You better lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. This is your thing, you only get one shot, so make your choices count, you got to think. Learning your math or the ABCs tested. I think they mastered plenty of these, the ACT, the SAT, the EOC, or the MAP started at the grade of three. Others got college credit through AP. Some of you got 5 for 4 years with straight D's. But you all made according to you should be pleased. So appease the pleas of your parents when they just say cheese, it doesn't matter the means or the path. Y'all got a common aftermath. Diploma in your hand, your grads after that. Go tackle the world, no turning back. Your life now becomes a solo track. Family and friends, you just support and cast. To yourself, you gotta make this path. Lord, go get my all, no effort lack. Lose yourself in this moment, you wanted, you earned it. If it's your thing, you only get one shot. So make your choices count, you got to think. Lose yourself in this moment, you wanted, you earned it. This is your thing, you only get one shot. So make those choices count, you got to think. So what's next, what happens after today? He's got his favor, it carries so much weight. It's even heavier than the sports net trophy you raise. And what you do with it is so clean, you'll say. And some would you stay and defend this play. For them, we'll bring rep in the USA. We hope that they're safe and that they stay okay. Each and every day on our conscience it will weigh. Some will choose to stray and join the labor force. With no remorse until their discourse is forced. Every single day looking for that light source. And if they fall down, get back up on the horse. Others go off and get the college degree. You see, they're free from high school, but they just have a seat. Some might stay local and some might flee. We're proud of you all for taking on the heat. Soon to be on night is the stress that's getting tired. Doing everything to make your mind get wider. Fighting the fight to make the future even brighter. At the end of the night, you know you're tired. It doesn't matter the path or what you do. Understand that your future is all on you. The more you grew, the more you knew. Just choose what's right and true and see it through. Do yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. You did your thing, you only get one shot from here on out. So make your choices count, you got to think. Lose yourself in this moment, you want it, you earned it. You did your thing, you only get one shot from here on out. So make your choices count, you got to think. Thank you, Professor Justin, congratulations.